pairing's a good idea, isn't it?
Really
Welcome
good.
Welcome back to Sunday Brunch. We're joined by John. Simon's sitting here because he's about to go on a bit of a ride, aren't
I am. I'm going to go on a roller coaster in a while, yeah.
Roller coaster thrill ride. Mm, yeah. Yeah, a virtual one. John, first time on the show. Tell us a bit about yourself.
So I am, as you said, a roller coaster designer. I get the fun job, every kid's dream job, to design rides for Merlin Entertainments and things like Alton Towers, Thorpe Park and Chessington.
How? Wow. How on earth did you do
So, I mean, I grew up playing the game Roller Coaster Tycoon. I fell in love with designing the rides and attractions. I thought, I want to do this as a job. So I went to university and studied architecture. And whilst I was just studying, I needed a bit of a side job to get some money. So I went and worked at the Sea Life Centre in Birmingham. And I was an entertainments host. And I was actually a costume character, a sheep. Long story why there was a sheep in the Sea Life Centre. But then out of that, I then applied for a job at Merlin Magic Making, which is essentially the powerhouse of creating new rides, attractions for the theme parks.
So people who normally design roller coasters and rides, are they normally from an architectural background then, or are you quite unique?
My colleagues and I, we come from all different backgrounds. Some of them are from theatre, you name it. There's all different backgrounds and all different skill sets as well. We've got people from finance, health and safety. There's so much that goes into building a roller coaster. Yeah.
Because I said to you, well, I said to John before the show, I was thinking, would you not have to have an engineering background? Because, you know, I could draw that, but I don't think it would be safe.
So essentially, my job is the really fun part. I dream it up. And then what we do is we go out and bring in architects, we bring in engineers, and they actually make what's called the magic of making these things a reality and make them work safely.
Why is there a sheep at a Sea Life Centre?
Long story short, it was an IP with Timmy the Sheep at the time, and they had a character roaming around the Sea Life Centre. He'd gone to the seaside.
Ah, OK. What is it you can't do? What are you not allowed to do, apart from... what aren't you allowed to do on a roller coaster?
I mean, as the dreamers, we try and say that it's limitless what we can do. Of course, there are some restrictions with things like safety in mind. You can't go above certain G-forces with certain roller coasters.
What G-forces is that?
It's normally when you're hitting around 4.5 to 5 G. We have some that get close, so we're currently transforming Nemesis at Alton Towers, which gets quite close.
I mean, Tim and I know what that means, what 4.5 Gs mean, but some of the viewers might not understand that.
So G is the G-force that we're kind of applying to you. It's a bit like what people in a spaceship might feel when they're launching off into space. It's that feeling of getting pushed down into your seat. But you can do the opposite. You can create the opposite to that, which is that weightless sensation. It creates a sensation you're floating, like spaceships. And that's what some of our roller coasters
do. You like being on roller coasters?
I love it.
Do you?
I mean, most of my spare time's riding roller coasters.
Yeah. Do you like being on roller coasters?
I hate them, Tim. Yeah. I'm dreading this.
Do you know what the thing about a roller coaster is, though? It's when you finish, you go, I did it.
Yeah.
That sense of accomplishment.
Yeah.
Just you and the other 10,000 people that day.
What's the maximum speed you're allowed to go, then, from a technical point of view?
I don't think there is actually a kind of limit to that. But what I can say is we are currently working on a roller coaster for Thorpe Park, which is going to be the UK's tallest and fastest roller coaster. I can't say just yet. We're keeping that just under wraps, but will be the fastest.
Tallest. Is that a thing to do, become the tallest? Because I always thought the ones which scare me most, the ones which go close to the ground, they're the ones, you know, when you're upside down, face first, and you're going, they're the ones which are terrifying. You think, I'm going to die. No, I'm not. Yes, I am.
And the ones that go backwards are horrible too.
And so what we've done is, like, recently I worked on a project for Chessington, which has a roller coaster that doesn't just go forwards, doesn't have one of those slow chain lifts. It's a launch coaster, so basically you're accelerating like a Formula One racing driver really, really fast, and then you do it all again backwards, essentially.
Is that the one that they're going to try now, or is it something else?
It is, yeah.
It is?
The one, Mandrill Mayhem at Chessington World of Events.
OK, so to explain what they're going to do. They're going to do virtual... The guests are doing this as well, are they?
Yeah,
so we've brought along with us some virtual reality headsets, and this is kind of part of the process of how we design roller coasters. We design them on a sketch, then we put them into 3D software, usually put them in VR to experience them ourselves. So you get to have a look at kind of part of that process. But what we've done now, we've built the ride, it's open at Chessington, we've put it in virtual reality so you can experience it right here in the studio.
Right, international celebrities, are you ready to don don your headgear? Okay. All right. I am about to go. Okay. Here we go. Right. I'm off.
Do we see what he's... Is this what he's seeing, roughly?
This is what you're seeing. So, we are currently launching...
Can I get off now, please? Right, so at the moment, this doesn't feel too terrifying. And is this about the right... This is about the speed that would actually be... Oh, that's not very nice, is it?
that you'd be travelling at. Down? Oh, I like the bit where you go upside down. Oh. It's fun, isn't it?
So this roller coaster actually has the first inversion or upside down moment for a ride at Chessington. So this will for kids, or probably their first upside down roller coaster. You don't just do it once, you do it twice, because now you get to the top of what is our Jaguar shrine in the world of Jumanji.
Where's that motion?
And now we go around it backwards.
Hey, I've had too much cheese for this.
Oh, my God.
this isn't nice, is it? Every time I go on one of these, then I wonder why I've done it. Because there's just something...
Oh, there we go. Oh, wow. Oh. This is like the toilets in Ibiza.
Oh, no, it's going again.
Oh, it's starting again.
No, that's the end of the
So we're now going backwards now.
Oh, it's starting again.
Oh, Lord.
Here we go. That's funny. It's going backwards.
Do you have to build in things like power cuts and stuff? What happens when...
There's loads of technical things that go into all these scenarios. Every scenario is thought through. So, yeah, safety is basically number one priority. Right.
Wow.
What did everyone think of that?
I'm doing it again.
Oh, yeah.
doing the virtual, it's not quite as bad, is it? You know what I mean? Well, bad from my point of view.
Yeah, because you've got no G-force.
Yeah, exactly.
You,
so yeah, that's the thing. So you kind of... But still, it gives that great impression. I'm sure if you're into roller coasters, that must be an amazing ride, but...
John, how long from the idea that you come up with to actually ending up in one of the theme parks, how long is that process?
It really varies. So, for instance, on World of Jumanji, I actually started that during lockdown, so I was kind of at home designing out sketches for this. So, and then we opened it this May, so that's probably about 4 years, maybe in the making, we were working on it.
So your job is you get up in the morning, you have a cup of coffee and some scrambled eggs, and then you go, right, shall I make a roller coaster?
Kind of. Every day is different. So one day I could be in the office developing ideas.
Sometimes you don't have scrambled eggs.
No, sometimes I don't have scrambled eggs either. And then another day we could just be on site art directing these attractions, because essentially they're a show, they're a theatre show.
Is it a competitive world, though? You know, you're looking at kind of other companies who develop them going, oh, they're doing good work in Germany at the moment kind of thing.
Absolutely. I mean, there's trade shows. We share ideas across the different parks around the world. I'm really fortunate I get to go and explore these places as well, which I love to do.
And John, just finally, is the moment, the great moment, is when you watch the first customers get off, or whatever they're called, punters get off, and they're smiling. Is that the bit for you?
Absolutely. When I see those guest reactions and those kids' faces when they're at a mandrill, that for me makes it.
Yeah, amazing. Thanks, John. It's really lovely to come on the show today.
Brilliant, John. Thank you, mate. Really.